Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about derivatives. This is the second part of derivatives. In the first part we have discussed up to forward contract, and in this video we will discuss about future contract, options and swap. Futures contract. A futures contract is a legal agreement to buy or sell a particular commodity, asset or security at a predetermined price at a specified time in the future. For example, there is a milkman who sells milk to the ice cream producer for making the ice creams. And the current market price of milk is 150 rupees per gallon. That means ice cream producer is purchasing milk at rupees 150 per gallon. Fine. But milkman is concerned about decreasing the prices of milk because of increasing competition among milk producers. So milkman offers a deal to ice cream producer to purchase the milk from him at 140 rupees per gallon for the next 3 years. Ice cream producer finds this deal profitable and comes in a contract with the milkman to purchase milk from him at 140 rupees per gallon for the next 3 years. This seems very much similar with forward contract, but the difference here is this, that future contracts are traded on an exchange. They have clearing houses that guarantees the transaction. That means milkman and ice cream producer will not trade privately but through the exchange. They will go to exchange where contracts are available, and the terms of contract will remain same for everyone regardless of who is the counterparty. This drastically lowers the probability of default. Fine. Similarity and difference between forward and futures contract. Futures contracts are standardized, unlike forward contracts. Forwards are similar type of agreements that lock in a future price in the present. But forwards are traded over the counter exchange and have customizable terms that are arrived at between the counterparties. Future contracts, on the other hand, will each have the same terms regardless of who is the counterparty. That means terms and conditions in the future contract will remain same for all. Now let's have a look to the difference between forward and futures contract. First is definition. A forward contract is an agreement between two parties to buy or sell an asset at a pre-agreed future point in time at a specified price, whereas futures contract is a standardized contract traded on a future exchange to buy or sell a certain underlying instrument at a certain date in the future at a specified price. Fine. Next is structure and purpose. Forward contracts customize according to customer needs and usually used for hedging, whereas futures contracts are standardized, usually used for speculation. Next is transaction method. Forward contracts are negotiated directly by the buyer and seller, whereas futures contracts are quoted and traded on the exchange. This is of differences. Market regulation. Forward contracts are not regulated by any governing body, whereas futures contracts are regulated by Commodities and Futures Trading Commission, which ensures pre and post trade transparency. Next is institutional guarantee. In forward contracts, the contracting parties take the guarantees for themselves, whereas in futures contracts, clearing houses take the guarantee for the contracting parties. Next is risk. As no clearing houses take the guarantee for the counterparty, so there is a high risk of default. Whereas there is a very low risk in case of futures contract, because future contracts are regulated by governing authority, and clearing houses take the guarantee for the counterparties. Next is initial guarantees deposit. In forward contracts, there is no initial guarantee of settlement, and only the forward contracts based on the spot price of underlying asset is paid. Fine. And in case of futures contracts, both parties must deposit an initial guarantee margin. For example, if ABC company and XYZ company signs a future contract, then they will be required to deposit initial guarantee in their accounts with the exchange, say rupees 5000. Now, if in the next day of signing the contract, ABC company getting loss of rupees 1000 because of change in the price of the underlying asset, then 1000 will get deducted from ABC's company's account and will be added to XYZ company's account, and hence the balance of ABC company's account will be 4000 and the balance of XYZ company's account will be 6000. and that's why it's written here that the value of the operation is marked to market rate with daily settlement of profit and losses. Fine. And the last is expiry date. In forward contracts, expiry date depend upon the transaction, whereas in futures contract, expiry date are standardized. Fine. Next type of derivative is option. An option is a contract which gives the right but not an obligation to buy or sell the underlying asset at a stated date and at a stated price. That means the buyer of the option purchases the right to buy or sell the underlying asset at a pre-specified date and a pre-specified time. And obviously, the buyer will not get this right for free. So, buyer of an option pays the premium and buys the right to exercise his option. And the writer of an option is the one who receives the option premium and therefore obliged to sell or buy the asset if the buyer exercises his option. Fine. And there are two types of option, that is call option and put option. Let us learn about these one by one. Type of option is call option. Call option is the one in which buyer of the option purchases the right to buy the underlying asset. For understanding this, I am quoting the same example which I have quoted in the beginning of first part of derivative video, in which a person pays 2 lakh rupees as a premium amount and purchases the right to buy the property at 45 lakh rupees after a year. And in addition to this, if buyer of the option do not want to purchase the property after 1 year at 45 lakh rupees, then the seller of the option or the writer of the option cannot force him for the same, because the buyer of the option has the right but not the obligation to purchase the property in future. Next is put option. A put option is one in which buyer of the option purchases the right to sell the underlying asset. So the basic difference between call option and put option is that in call option, the buyer of the option purchases the right to buy the underlying asset, whereas in put option, the buyer of the option purchases the right to sell the underlying asset. Fine. And for understanding this, let us see this example. A person purchases a debenture of 5,000 at the interest rate of 10% per annum for 10 years. And also, he purchases a put option by paying 500 as a premium amount to sell the debenture after 5 years if he finds any profitable investment opportunity to invest. Fine. Now, if he will see any profitable investment opportunity after 5 years, then he will sell the 10% debentures and will invest in the new security. And if he will not find any profitable investment opportunity after 5 years, then he will not sell the debentures and will continue to receive investment on the receive interest on the same debenture. Next and last type of derivative is swap. In simple terms, a swap, meaning from its name, is exchanging one item for another, like a barter trade. A financial swap is a derivative contract where one party exchanges or swaps the cash flows or value of one asset for another. Swaps do not trade on exchange and retail investors do not generally engage in swaps. Rather, swaps are over-the-counter contracts preliminary between business or financial institutions that are customized according to the needs of both the parties. Swaps are used in order to hedge, speculate, or for reducing the risk. Basically, there are two types of swaps, that is interest rate swap and currency swap. Let us learn about these one by one. Interest rate swap. Interest rate swaps involve exchange of interest rates between two parties. Interest rate swaps usually involves the exchange of a fixed interest rate for a floating interest rate and vice versa to reduce or increase the exposure to fluctuation in interest rate or to obtain the marginally lower interest rate that wouldn't be possible without the swap. For understanding interest rate swap, let us understand this example. There are two companies, Company A and Company B. Company A has to pay fixed interest rate of 2.5% for his investment. Fine. And Company B has to pay floating interest rate of LIBOR plus 1% for his investment. Now, LIBOR means London Interbank Offer Rate. Fine. For reducing interest rate, company A wants to exchange his fixed interest rate for the floating interest rate because company A has a prediction that LIBOR rate can be reduced in the future. Fine. And at the same time, company B do not want to take the risk of increase or decrease in LIBOR rate and want to exchange floating interest rate for the fixed rate. Fine. So, with the help of interest rate swap, both the companies will exchange their interest rate. But the point to be noted here is that in the interest rate swap, companies will not pay the full interest amount, but only the difference between fixed and floating interest rate will be exchanged. Our last topic is currency swap. A currency swap is a derivative contract between two parties that involves the exchange of interest payment as well as exchange of principal amount that are denominated in different currencies. For understanding this, let us take an example. There are two companies in two different countries, namely American company and Indian company. American company wants to finance a project in India and is able to borrow the fund at 6% in US. But it requires a loan in rupees for an investment in India where the relevant borrowing rate is 9%. Fine. At the same time, Indian company wishes to finance a project in US where its borrowing rate is 11% compared to its borrowing rate at 8% in India. So, American company can borrow US dollar for 6% and then it can lend the funds to the Indian company at 6%. Similarly, Indian company can borrow rupees at 8% and then lend the funds to the US company. So, with the help of currency swap, both the companies can get the fund at lower interest rate. Now, the question arises that how Indian company and American company will get to know about each other and their requirements. There will be a bank known as Swap Bank, which will act as a mediator between these two companies. Fine. And these companies will contact to Swap Bank and deal will be finalized through this bank only. Swap Bank do not play the role of mediator for free but will charge for the same. For example, in the above case, Swap Bank can borrow the fund from American company and at 6% but can lend to Indian company at 6.5%. Right? And the difference will be the profit made by the Swap Bank. Similarly, Swap Bank can borrow the funds from Indian company at 8% and can lend to the American company at 8.5%. So, this is all about currency swap. This was all about derivatives. Thank you for watching.